All right, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you can hear me okay. This is The Shmoopy going live. We'll have to see if the quality of the stream may need a little restart. We are dropping a few frames here and there, but hopefully it's nothing major. I've been changing the quality around because we're doing something a little different today. Hopefully you can all hear me. Mind reading fart. I'm sorry to hear you got up so early, but welcome to the stream. Hope you're doing well. Here we go, guys. Let's see how we get on. And everyone else who's joining us this morning, nice and early. Well, it's afternoon in Britain. Morning in America. Okay, here we go, guys. Something different. Right here. Right now. Let's go. Hopefully you can see me. I am the Shmoopies. We are live. I have to use my headset because my area of effect mic is rubbish. Let me know if you can see me okay. We are in the kitchen. Somewhere a little bit different. And I found Pooh Bear. He escaped from the chair. If anyone's been following me on Twitter or on the Discord. But he's in here, in the kitchen with us. He's joining us for this cooking extravaganza. Let's see if you guys can see me in. Just tell me if you're getting any lag. We can see you? Excellent. Let me know if the lag is bad at all. And we'll see how we get on. So, what are we making, I hear you say? Well, today, we're going to make some bread and butter pudding. A British favourite. Very typical British dish. Nice, sweet dessert. So after, we're going to do that first, because it takes a little bit while. And then we're going to make, oh no, is he getting honey? No, look, he could be in the honey pot. Stay poo. And then we're going to make a risotto. Oh God, there's a water here, but be careful. And then we're going to make a risotto. So we're going to cook up something like a little Italian dish, but something using leftovers. Basically, this is going to be a using up leftovers stream. So you've got some bread that's maybe a couple of days old. You don't really want to eat it. You can use it for your bread and butter pudding. You've got some chicken left over. I have a chicken that I roasted on Sunday that's got some bits left. I'm going to use that in my risotto. But you can use fresh chicken as well. Let's see how we get on. And I hope you enjoy the stream, guys. So that's the plan. If you want to see any of the recipes, exclamation mark blog will take you to the blog where the recipes are. Let's see how we get on. I hope you're all doing well. This is something I've done before, but only once. So I've changed a few things this time around. You have to let me know what you think. See how we get on. Is my tea ready? Yes, look at that, my tea is brewed. Very important to have well brewed tea. Plug that down there. Sweda! How you doing? You are backwards, or your shirt. I am backwards. That's the problem with wearing a t-shirt with writing on it. Oh, I never thought about it. Rubbish. I might have to go change my t-shirt. Don't look at my t-shirt. I am backwards. The reason is, this way round, I work this way through the kitchen, which is across your screens. If I go the other way, my body blocks half the stuff and it looks a bit ridiculous. So this way I'm opening up the kitchen. Does mean my t-shirt is backwards. Never thought about that. Maybe my t-shirt is just backwards. No, my t-shirt is backwards. It's nothing to do with the camera. Oops. Mistakes were made. It happens. Let me know if you're lagging at all. We seem to be pretty stable, so I think we're gonna go with it. Leave the tunes on, hopefully they're not too loud. And this time I've got notifications and stuff, and I've got all this stuff set up, so hopefully you can see me. All right, let's roll. So, you can see the leftover washing up that I was doing earlier. Bread and butter pudding. Basically, it uses old bread. So let's say you've got some old bread, you want to use it up. Basically, the first thing you do is slice it. So we're going to start off with slicing it. This is going to be kind of boring for a few minutes, because I'm literally just going to be slicing bread, which is kind of boring, but it's the way I have to do it, because, well, I've got bread here that needs sliced. So what we'll do is we should be able to press a little button here. Oh, it's a little bit closer zoomed in than I would like, but it's not too bad. Go onto this camera where we can see the bread. Look at that, two cameras. It's a bit posh, I tell you. So you're looking to make them quite thin slices, because that's what you want. And like I said, you want your bread to be a couple of days old. This actually isn't as old as I would like. It just happens to be the only bread that I've got. So we're just going to slice it into slices, which is kind of boring, but you can buy sliced bread, obviously. This is unsliced, just that's what I buy. I buy unsliced bread, so we'll see how we get on. Looks like the time on the oven is backwards too. Oh, no, Sweda, shush. You've discovered my secret, that I always flip my camera. No real reason. I just do it. It's just something that I do. Always flip my camera. So, basically, you want to slice this into thinner slices than that. The first two were quite nice. The last one's not so good. We'll keep going through it. Hey, at least you can see. I mean, that's kind of cool with the second camera. It seems to be working, so that's a bit better slice. A bit thinner. Remember, guys, when you're chopping, it's really important that you hold your equipment properly. Don't chop your fingers off. Best way to do that, Johnny, if he's in the chat, will tell you. I think I did see him around. He said he was going to be live. Good knuckle position. So if you ever cut, you cut down your knuckles rather than... So you can see here I'm pushing my knuckle against the blade and holding the rest of the bread behind my two fingers. And that basically gives me stability. When you're cutting bread, really sawing action. You're not pushing down at all. You want to make sure you're slicing through the bread. That's the reason why a bread knife is serrated. Bread knife is serrated for a reason. Use it. So let's see how we get on. I'll just keep slicing through this. So the first part of the stream is a little boring, but it does give us time for people to realize we're live, to come in and be like, oh, what's this Shmoopy doing? Why is he doing cooking? What a weirdo. But that's kind of why we're here. Yep, we'll have a closer look on all the breadcrumbs around. Well, look, I'm chopping bread. What do you expect, Swader? It's the way it works. When you cut bread, you get breadcrumbs. You maybe didn't know this. It's okay, Swader, I've even got a leek for you in this dish. Who have we got joined us? Been here since you started, and yeah, hand positions in cooking are what you need to know. Exactly, Johnny. Welcome to the stream, Johnny. You did say you were going to join us. So I wondered if you were around. How are you getting on today, Johnny? Welcome. I hear you might have had a bad day, so I got from your message on Discord, so I hope I can cheer you up. Right, at the moment, I'm at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 slices. I'm going to keep going. The recipe I've put up uses 8 in a 1-liter dish. Now, the one on the blog. Now, my actual recipes... It's going to be slightly more than that because my dish is a bit bigger. So we're going to do that. What are we making? What's your name? I'm trying to read it. New Zealand Payne? Or is it NZ Payne? Welcome to the stream. Today we're making bread and butter pudding. And we're also going to make a risotto. If you can check out the recipes, if you type in !! blog in the chat, you'll find out what we're getting on. Unfortunately, my chat is a little bit further away from my kitchen than I would like. So when you write things, I have to take a minute to come and read it. Well, maybe I'm getting sliced bread, then I don't have to cut the bread. That is better. If you want to get sliced bread is definitely better. It's just this is what I buy, so this is what I've got left over. Basically, it's just what I'm using. I was going to try and pre-slice some of it, so it wasn't quite so boring. The first 10 minutes of me just slicing bread. Oh, that was a bit rubbish. Ignore that. Quick, get rid of that one. Nobody will notice. Yeah, I'm in New Zealand. How did you know? Oh, I don't know. I don't know, NZ Payne. I've got no clue. I guessed. Lucky guess. I'm going to flip over my bread because I've cut it a bit squint now. It's mostly because I'm talking. Now I'll cut out the slice that's squint. This bread is slightly older, so it's okay to use it. Again, this is a good use of leftover bread. You have some leftover bread. Right. Cut through the last slice. Fantastic. Okay, so. Got some bread sliced. Nice and easy. Let's pop it back onto... So yeah, we got some bread sliced, nice and easy, nice big stack of bread. The dish that we're using today, I think, is not in the cupboard. I got it out already. Look at that. Organization, guys. Organization. This is the dish we're using today. It's a 2-liter dish, just about. It's a pie dish. And we're going to be putting our bread into that once it's ready. So I'll pop that on the edge. Basically, because it's bread and butter pudding, you need some butter. You know, you can't just make bread and butter pudding without butter. So, got some butter here. It's a new pack that I'm opening. I'm using slightly salted butter. You can use unsalted butter if you want. I wouldn't recommend salted butter. Unsalted, it's probably okay. Maybe lack a little bit of flavour. But we're going to go with some salted butter. So I hope you're doing well. I hope you're all having a good day. I'm just going live. So we're just starting. We're making our sweet first. NZ Payne, thank you very much for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Thank you for being awesome and clicking that follow button. I hope you look forward to joining us in the future as we do more of these cooking streams, as well as our normal streams, which are survival-based. Now, what was I saying? Yeah, bread and butter pudding. What are we? I'm going to be slow at typing. Yeah, you got some bad news on the phone this morning. So I'm here to be cheered up as usual. Well, I hope we can cheer you up. Don't worry about being slow. We'll let you out off with it. Chat box is maybe a little bit big. Again, this is a new setup that I'm using. I'm just trying this out. So, it's bread and butter pudding. Bread and butter pudding wouldn't be bread and butter pudding if you just had bread. So, butter. So, I've got some butter. Like I said, I'm using slightly salted. And I've got a palette knife. Now, this is a palette knife. It's very good for spreading. You'll notice it's a bit damp. The reason is I've warmed it up because I don't want my butter to be too hard. So I've just warmed up. I've got a bit of kitchen roll to dry it off with as we go. Nice warm in a mug. We'll just pop this back over to... Did that work? No? Hello? Whee! Onto this screen. So, we're just going to spread our butter, bread with some butter. So, how am I going to do this on the screen? Do that there. We'll try this. Give it a little scrape, get some butter onto the knife. Don't need too much. Just a nice... I'm going to get me something to eat because it's making me hungry. A sword? It's not a sword, Sweda. It's a knife. And we'll just spread it on. Again, palette knives are designed for spreading. So you can look at my terrible spreading technique. I'm really bad at spreading. And this bread is a bit soft for me. Normally I would use something a bit harder. But, again, this is a good use for leftover bread. But my bread just hasn't aged well enough. And that gives you an idea of what we're looking for. A nice even spread of bread. On butter on the bread. So I'm going to keep doing this. And you guys are going to hopefully chat to me. Keep me sane. Because I hate spreading butter. And it's just a nightmare job. And I'm just going to keep doing this, basically. And look at you guys and see how you guys get on. So how's everyone's day going? It's a Tuesday. It's almost middle of the week. You're nearly at Friday. Don't worry, guys. I'm here to keep you entertained on that journey down to Friday. Okay, so let's just spread that on there. Again, my spreading technique is very poor. You're looking for an even spread of butter if you can. Now, we're going to cut the crusts off. So I'm going to stack my bread like I was making a sandwich. Bread, butter, bread. In a little sandwich section. That's the plan. And we'll see how we get on. So I'm going to clean my palette knife. Because it's a bit cold. Like I said, I really wanted to do some of this prep before I started. But I didn't really have time. So I just have to spread butter with you guys. You guys can be with me while I spread my butter. In fact, I'm going to get some softer butter. It's Wednesday here. Of course it is, NZ Payne. Of course it is. Wednesday. Wow, already. That's really... I find that like quite mind-blowing, if I'm honest. That it can be one day of the week here and another day somewhere completely different. I find it quite interesting that you guys have already reached your Wednesday. I'm going to switch my butter because this butter's softer because it's been out for longer. And this is actually slightly different butter than I would use. This is unsalted, but it's been out of the fridge for a while, so it means I can get it on. So you're a common watcher of food streams, Mr. Payne? We'll be able to rewatch this. Yeah, of course you can. I'll put it up on YouTube. Probably not the whole thing. I'll probably put a summary up on YouTube. And this will be on the VOD. You can watch this for at least 2 weeks after I finished it. But maybe longer if you're lucky. Basically. So I've moved my whole setup to the kitchen. Even Pooh Bear's come with me. Even Pooh Bear's come into the kitchen. Although I haven't got my chair. My chair I left in the other room, but my computer, my monitor, we're all in here. How are we doing for lag? Are we dropping too many frames? Let me know if you guys are getting some lag. Because I am streaming on a slightly higher quality than normal, because I'm not trying to stream a game, I'm just streaming myself. So I figured just for myself, be okay. Gotta keep the knife nice and warm. It's important to keep it clean and warm, because then you get a better spread of butter. Like I said, this is my butter spreading stream. It's kind of boring, I know, I apologize, but hey ho. We'll just get it cleaned. Get it spread. You know, butter. Poof. How exciting. He's just spreading butter. What a stream. But hey, I tell you, once I've spreaded the butter, it's going to be really tasty. I mostly watch anything in creative streams. Oh, okay, cool. Cool. Like I said, I've not spent too much time on the creative section of the channel. I spent a little bit of time in food streams, just to get an idea of what I was going to do myself. I'm not a big creative person. I don't do a lot of art. I don't do a lot of photography. I can't make anything. I'm very bad at making stuff. Scott, welcome to the stream. How you getting on? This isn't a sword sweater. Don't get excited. Buttered teddy if an accident happens. Just whack the teddy with the butter. He'll be alright. He'll be safe, guys. He'll be safe. Don't worry about the teddy. He'll be fine. Hey! Even if he isn't fine, he'll be alright. Right, so we're going to keep spreading our butter. Scott, we're making bread and butter pudding to start with, and then we're making something a bit different. So this is the easy part. This is using some old bread. If you've got some bread left over, maybe you forgot to eat it, maybe you bought too much, maybe you had friends around and they didn't eat quite as much bread as you expected. That's what normally happens for me. This is what we're making, so it's a good dish. You want a nice liberal spreading of bread, as much butter as you can get on the bread as possible. Again, I meant to do some of this prep before I started, but it took me a little while to get the stream set up, so didn't quite have as much time as I wanted. Yeah, the food goes in creative, so I enjoy watching food as well. Yeah, of course, man, of course. I must say, the first cooking stream I did was quite exciting. The first cooking one was a pretty good stream. I really enjoyed it. We made a Welsh dish, exclamation mark recipe. I think the recipes are still up for that. They're on the blog as well, actually. And that was the last dish we made. This is a newer stream. So, okay, I'm going to ditch this butter because I'm not using it. Put that back in the fridge. I don't want it going out of date. Like I said, one of the keys about this is to keep your palette knife warm. The cleaner and warmer your palette knife is, the easier it is to spread the butter. So, it's good. How are you doing this morning, Scott? It's nice and early for you. Hope you're awake. Hope you're doing well. For Scott, it's 8 o'clock in the morning. So a bit different to NZ Payne, where it's already Wednesday. How is the weather in New Zealand at the moment? Is it a bit cold? Or is it still quite warm? I'm trying to think. It must be pretty close to winter for you guys, so I hope you're doing well. And have you got any Olympic hopefuls that you're keeping an eye on as well? That's the other question, of course, to ask. I don't know much about the New Zealand Olympics. I saw a bit of the Australian eventing yesterday, but not anything from New Zealand. Bosh! Welcome to the stream, my friend. I'm doing very well. This is my kitchen. This is Pooh Bear. He escaped, if you've been following me on Twitter. He escaped from my chair. He dragged me into the kitchen and said, Shmoopy, you have to make... I'm waving my knife. You have to make bread and butter pudding. Winter's nearly finished? Okay, cool. He said, you have to make some bread and butter pudding. And that's what we're doing. Maybe I should have written that in the title. Making some bread and butter pudding and then a risotto. I might change the title to reflect that. Because at the moment it just says making some food. Which is kind of cool, because that is what we're doing. But it's good. Where's Adam? I know. Where's Adam? That's a good question. He could be here with me. He is in Edinburgh. I haven't actually had a chance to meet up with him. He was supposed to message me and he didn't. And I haven't chased him because I didn't know if he was back yet in Edinburgh. I saw his Twitter. I saw that he was supposed to be in Edinburgh. But I'll have to see if I can find him. Lamb cowl. Yeah, it was what we made last time. It was really good. I think the only hope we've got is shoulders shot put in the sevens. I mean, the sevens will certainly be good to see. I must say, New Zealand is my second rugby team, and that's got nothing to do with being a Glory supporter, but everything to do with supporting Jonah Lamu. I'm a big, big long-lost love with Jonah Lamu, and I know that he has unfortunately left us for hopefully a better place, the great rugby pitch in the sky, but what a man. I have a lot of respect for him, so big fan of his. Just saying, but I love making this when I was in the kitchen. Bread and butter pudding is an easy dish to make. That's the thing. It's just so simple. As long as you know, it's a bit time consuming spreading all this butter on bread, and I'm really bad at spreading. So once I get the spreading done, which I should have already done, I should have blue-peated it. Here's one I made earlier. But like I said, I didn't really have time. So making sure I'm not missing anyone's messages. John Lamu and Jerry Collins. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, one of the best players that ever lived. Indeed. So I've always supported New Zealand. I think that being Welsh and also supporting the Scarlets, I support Llanelli Scarlets, it gives me sort of a love affair with New Zealand rugby as well. I think just with the nature of the relationship between New Zealand and the Scarlets. So that was always nice. Actually, do you know, I can't remember who it was. Was it Dan Carter? Was visiting some friends or someone in England. And my friends had a rugby sevens tournament, and put on a pair of boots and was like, oh, can I play? And he wasn't arrogant about it. I mean, this is Dan Carter we're talking about. It's one of the... Is that his name? Yeah, the New Zealand rugby player. He was really not arrogant at all. He was like, oh, look, guys, if you've got some space, I'd love to have a game. And this is one of the best rugby players in the world, asking my friend's team if he can join them. And they're like, oh, of course we have space. You get sacked. Get on the bench. So he came on and played a couple of games. He was a really nice guy, apparently. Just came in and had a chat. Right, that's us nearly spread all our butter on bread, which is good, because I'm getting bored of this. Because it takes forever. Again, using a palette knife does make it a lot quicker, but it takes forever. Okay, so spread all this on here. So, bread and butter pudding. I'm going to change the title. I'm going to go update the title before I get stuff all over my hands. And I can't touch my computer because I hate touching my computer with my greasy hands. Okay, stack all my bread up there. So, that says bread stack. Now, I'm just going to quickly change the title before we go any further. Oh, how do I do this? Because I've not got a Twitch window open. Hold on. Let me just open up a Twitch window. I just want to update the title because let's say what we're making in the title because that's a bit more fun, isn't it? Than just... So anyway, I hope everyone's doing well. Bosh, I hope you're having a good day. Welcome to the stream. I probably sound a bit more Welsh when I'm cooking. Cooking makes me feel Welsh inside. Cooking some food. Right, let's have a look. We're making...
Say what we're making in the title.
Oh, no, that's myself. Sharp. Shmoopy. So anyway, I hope everyone's doing well. Bosh, I hope you're having a good day. Okay, sorry. Took me a while to get rid of myself. I like bread and butter pudding. It tastes good. Yeah, cooking some food. Let's have a look. Bread and... Do you get bread and butter pudding in America, Scott? Butter pudding to follow risotto. One of the easiest things to make, risotto. Also, when you cook risotto, you feel like you've actually done something. Right, that's me updated the stream title, so makes me feel a little bit better about life, really, to be honest. Cool. Right. That's that done. Excellent. So, I'm back. Sorry, guys. Disappeared for a minute. Yeah, so, right. So, we've stacked our butter, like I said. We've stacked it in a very set way. We've got it done so that you've got bread, butter, bread. That's what we're looking for. No, we don't. Never heard of it. Okay, so... Banana bread is the best. Banana bread is quite nice. This is quite badly spread, but it'll be okay. It'll still taste nice. Like I said, I rushed the end. Now what we're going to do is we're going to cut the crusts off. So because it's like this, that means I can stack them. I'm just going to get rid of some of the crumbs from here. I've got to watch out. I have a four-legged friend with me today. So my four-legged friend would probably love to get some of this bread. So I'm trying to avoid her coming into the room and taking me out. I'll do it very quietly. We have bread, butter, and pudding, though. Ah, well, you see. So this is easy, right? So what you do is you get your bread, and you take off the crusts, because you don't really want the crusts in your bread and butter pudding. So I'm going to stack my bread three high, because I'm confident with a knife. I know how to use a knife. Let's just move that over there. How am I looking? Put this here. Where are we going? There. And then I'm just going to take off the crust. So you can see here, just nice and gentle. Through there, remove the crusts, go down the side. Again, this is why my spreading is okay, because I'm taking off the crust. I'm taking off a lot of the stuff that I haven't spread right out to the edges. Down here, and down this side as well. So that's me cut off the bread. You can see my hand position is quite important, making sure that my thumb is behind my fingers, and I'm pushing the knuckle into the knife. It means I can never cut myself, because there's no bits of me sticking out. If there are no bits of you sticking out, you're not going to cut yourself. So, then what I'm going to do... So I'm going to slice it in half. Excellent. Now I'm going to take it apart. This isn't going to work, is it? Yeah, it is. Okay, so I'm going to peel it apart. I'm going to lay it into my dish, which I'll show you what we're doing in a second with that. It's the only problem with stacking it to slice it is that sometimes it doesn't peel apart very well. Be fine. There we go. Do you know, I've never made bread and butter pudding. I was talking about what I could make on the stream with Lady Shmoopy, and she was like, just make something that you know what to do. And I'm like, yeah, I'll make bread and butter pudding. She was like, have you ever made bread and pudding? I was like, no. I also love zucchini bread. Oh, I've never had zucchini bread. Zucchini, if you're in Britain, is is it courgette or is it cucumber? Uh-oh. Don't actually know the answer to that. Well, whichever one it is, it sounds quite interesting. Zucchini bread. Wow. Well, that certainly sounds a little different, I tell you that. So you can see here, I'm peeling this open. Oh, that one fell apart because I was watching the screen rather than watching myself. And we're going to take the crusts off this one again. Let's go for this. Here we go. So we're going to remove the crusts. Hey, great if you don't like crusts, eh? Like I said, you want to make sure you're looking after your fingers when you're using your knife. Always make sure that your thumb is behind your knuckles and you can never cut yourself. Never had zucchini bread. I'll have to try that. Maybe find a recipe at some point. Put that in, into triangles, because triangular bread tastes better. Everyone knows that. Get rid of that as well. One more slice down here. So the quality of this screen isn't as good. Obviously, this is a very old webcam of mine. I'm just trying out something a little different today. We'll see how we get on. Okay, in the first cooking stream we did, we had it set up so that we cut into things, but this is a little bit different today. Excellent. What are you saying in the chat, guys? Not the crusts! No! No! I know the crusts, Swader. But hey, sometimes crusts are just evil. Okay, so that's my bread sliced. So let's get onto the other camera so we can show you what we're doing here. That didn't work. Why did that not work? Hey! Other camera, please. Okay, now it's not working. No idea why. Hey, there we go. You can see the mess that I made up here with all the crusts. So what we've got is we've got all the bread and we're layering it into the dish in triangular layers. It's okay to have a few gaps because we're going to fill those in with the next layer. So we're going to go two layers on here. My dish, like I said, is a little bit bigger than I would have liked just because I couldn't find the smaller one. I think Lady Shmoopy's stolen it. One there. So we're just going to keep layering this on, as you can see here. Looks like you let a bit of crust on your bread. Yeah, there's a small bit left on there. Be okay. It's okay if you don't take it all off. The idea is to take off most of it. There we go, look. It's fine. Nobody will notice. Suddenly, I'm only going to feed this to Lady Shmoopy. She's not going to notice. So, we're going to cut through this. So we're going to go for a second layer. Before we do the second layer, we're going to add the next most important, the next ingredient. So, other ingredients for this dish include raisins. So that's just the prep. This is now how we construct the dish. That's all the prep done. It's just a case of slicing and buttering bread. Really easy. I've used about 15 slices. Now we're going to get some sultanas in this little bag here, bought from the lovely Tesco's. And we're just going to throw a bit of them on into the dish. You can see nice and easy there.
Okay, search for traps.
Who's searching for traps? Bosh! You searching for traps. Welcome to the stream. Thank you very much for clicking that host button. I appreciate it. We'll keep an eye out for traps while your followers come here and search. I was always told that if you get crusts, you get curly hair. They lied. I still got curly hair. I got told that as well when I was a kid. So add some sultanas, a bit of cinnamon as well. Now, how much? This is really hard. You want a nice layer, and then you want a couple of pinches of cinnamon. You don't want a huge amount. Now, this is a very old recipe that I'm using. I'm just using some cinnamon, self-ground. I'm just going to throw it on. Lady Shmoopy's going to hate this. She doesn't like cinnamon. I'm going to put on 2 pinches, just so it's a nice layer of cinnamon. Then I'm going to go for another layer of bread. This time, I'm going to do the bread going a slightly different angle. I'm going to go reverse to the way I went before. And the reason for this is just this. You want butter side facing up, guys. That's really important. And the reason is just to cover up all the gaps. You want to fill in all the gaps so that there are no gaps left in the bread if we can avoid it. So while you're doing this, guys, you want your oven on about 180 degrees, which is gas mark 4, 350 degrees Fahrenheit, I think. I'll have to check that if you're a Fahrenheit user. Just chuck that in there. See, building up nice layers here of bread and butter. A little bit of crust left on that one. Just pull that off. Open this up. Pop that on there. There we are, you see? So, nice and easy. So now, once we've done this, we're going to have to make a custard. I don't know if anyone's ever made custard before. It's not tubby custard like the Teletubbies eat. This is decent custard. We're going to chuck some more sultanas on the top. Did you preheat the oven? Yes, my oven is on. I put it on before we started streaming. So preheat your oven, 180 degrees. We've still got a little bit of prep to do before this can go in the oven, actually. You probably don't need to preheat your oven before you start buttering your bread because it takes actually a little while to do the next stage. Excellent. So, that's my sultanas on. I've used about 200 grams. Again, because I'm using slightly more than the recipe says, I've kind of mixed things up a little bit because, unfortunately, that's just how it happened. Another couple of pinches of cinnamon on the top. That's a 1 pinch. And that's another pinch there. Fantastic. Put anything left over in there. That's freshly ground cinnamon as well, so it's a bit strong. If you're not used to using it. So, that's done. I'm going to clear this so I've got a bit more space. Because I'll show you what we've done in a second. What I can do is I can just ditch that in there. It gets rid of all the crumbs. I'll use this later, so I'll just put it on the table over here. Got a table behind me. So Shmoopies is cooking again! I am indeed. Kiresh to Hatch 2016, welcome to the stream. Hope you're doing well. How are you getting on? Excuse the mess that I've just left. I've just taken all the crusts off butter. So off bread and buttered about a whole loaf of bread. So I've got quite a lot left over. I'm going to keep out these bits because I can use these to make breadcrumbs with. And we're going to ditch the crusts. Ren, welcome to the stream. Good job, you have a wireless headset. R2 Christmas, welcome to the stream as well. Hope you're doing well. I have no Mr. Jeffries today. I'm sorry. No Mr. Humphreys. He's not here. This headset's not wireless, Ren. Look, there's a cable going all the way to my computer. Welcome to the stream, Ren. Welcome to the stream, R2. And welcome to the stream, Kirato Hatchet as well, 2016. How are you doing, guys? Good to see you. I am cooking again. I have no Mr. Humphreys. He's abandoned me for England. Could you believe it? He's left Scotland and gone to England. Ah, drop some bread on the floor. Uh-oh, don't tell the dog. She'll be in here in a speedy thing. Kiracho! I don't know how to say your name. Kira? Kia Serato Hatch? I have no idea how to say your name, I'm sorry. I'm probably completely butchering it. 2016. Anyway, Hatch, welcome to the stream. Thank you very much for the follow. I do appreciate it. Thank you for being awesome. I'm going to read what Ren said in a second, because I can't quite see it. Don't mind me while I just tidy up this mess, because there's crumbs everywhere. There we go, into my food recycling bin. That can go in the waste. Get off the stuff off the floor before the dog gets it. Excellent. So, made some space. Let's pop this over here. Not bad, thanks. Yourself, Scott. Bread looks dangerously close to the power outlet. I know. Bread. Bread and power outlets. You've got to be careful, honestly. No, they're switched off. You're right. Move the bread, please. Bread's moved. All right, let's have a look. So if we go to this one, be busy moving. Oh man, that's crazy. Sorry to hear that you've been moving. Let's pop this in here. So what are we saying? So, where's Mr. Humphreys? Is that headset part of my head? It is indeed. You love bread and butter pudding. I mean, I really enjoy bread and butter pudding. I think it's great fun. Really tasty. Really, really tasty dish. So this is what we've got so far, guys. You can see here we've got our sultanas. Got our bread nicely layered, butter side up in our dish, ready to go in the oven. So, the key part of bread and butter pudding. I thought that was an oven cam. No, this is my work surface. Hope you get internet soon, Ren. Can't not have internet. So yeah, so basically we've got this ready. Now all we have to do is make up a custard. So you can't see me right now because I'm going into the fridge and getting out a few things we're going to need for the custard. Oh no! It's all right. I only dropped it. Nothing exploded. We're all good. Just make sure I get the right amount of stuff. Need my eggs. And I need some sugar as well. How much sugar do I need? 25 grams. Easy. Okay. Is that sultanas or poo? It's sultanas. You need sultanas. Actually, technically they're raisins. But, unfortunately, thing. I realize there's some poo in your bread and butter pudding. I know. It looks dangerously close to the edge. Well, you know, sometimes that's just the way it is, guys. Gotta be careful. Put all that in there. Gonna need that later. Oh, we've been joined by a four-legged friend. Oi, shift. Hey, out my way. I've got a dog in my way. You have to bear with me, guys. So, the custard. This is going to be quite an important part. Now, the only thing we don't have is a pot cam. I haven't been able to do a pot cam, so you're just going to have to listen to me and trust me when I say I'm using a pot. So, what we've got is milk, cream, eggs, and sugar. We need 25 grams of sugar. It's the only thing I haven't measured out. Where is my sugar? Where did I put it? Here it is. This is the problem with not having Mr. Jeffries. No worries. Thank you very much, New Zealand Pain. I hope you enjoyed the small amount of stream that you've watched. If you ever are around, do join us again. Thank you very much for hanging out. Good night. Hope you have a good day. hope you have enjoy the rest of your Wednesday, because it is Wednesday for you. So early. So we need 25 grams of sugar, 2 eggs, and some milk. Okay, some sugar. Oh yeah, you see, nice and easy. Just wasn't prepared. What's the use-by date on the milk? I don't know. 15th of August? Quite a long way away for me. Make sure it's not off. Hey, best way to check it's not off is to just sniff it. Milk lasts for a couple of days after its use-by date, so make sure you smell it before you use it. So 350 milliliters of milk. I've lost my measuring jug. Here it is. Move, dog. Hey. Thank you. All right, I have an animal at my feet. She wasn't supposed to be in here, but she obviously heard me drop some food. I think it's brand new. It's not even open yet. I only bought this today. But like I said, best way to tell if it's off is to just sniff it. You can use milk past its sell-by date as long as you smell it before you use it. So 350 milliliters of milk, 50 milliliters of double cream, and what you want to do. Excellent. Get them into your pot. Pot on a low heat. Something about low to medium heat. And you want to bring that to nearly a boil, not quite a boil. You can see I've spilt and made a mess. There we go. So to nearly a boil. There's a use-by date on the on the milk. Like I said, just give it a sniff. Good shout, Corretto Hatch. Good shout. Can I take a closer look at the clock on the wall? This is Lady Shmoopy's Bugs Bunny clock. This smells terrible, uses. Well, that's true. Does sniff work on all items of food? Not really. Some of them, though. Some of them. Now I've got to move it because I won't be able to get it back on the hook. Oh, God! Gracie, move! Labradors getting in the way. So, you want this to boil, bring to a nice temperature. While that's warming up, you don't want it to boil. You want to get it to scalding, so it's nearly boiled. Just not quite there. We're going to crack some eggs into a bowl and add some sugar, and we're going to whisk it. Now, normally I do this using a whisker, an electric mixer. But basically, sniff the clock. But the clock's off! How can I sniff it? I wouldn't sniff the clock. Oh man, it was smell of kitchen. Ugh. Kitchen smell is like one of the worst smells in the world. If you ever work in a professional kitchen, you would know that. It's just like the chill. If you walk into a chill, it just smells so bad. So, what we're going to do is we're going to get 2 eggs. Again, make sure your eggs aren't off. A great way of telling if your eggs are off are to give them a shake. This box is actually the new box. Best way to tell if your eggs are off is to give them a shake. Now, these eggs went out of date on the 27th of May. So, if it goes solid when you shake it, it's normally a fair sign that it's off. This one is off. This one is not. So we'll ditch that one. That one's not off either. Fantastic. Again, there's no point in wasting food. If you can, just use it. Again, when you crack them, make sure you sniff them. Fortunately, not super prepared. Forgot to get out a thing to crack my eggs into. So, I'm going to crack my egg. Give it a smell. Smells fine. Chuck it into my bowl. Easy. Again, you can pretty much smell anything. I must say, you can smell anything, but there are some things I wouldn't eat out of date. Certain meats and stuff. But look at this, guys. I'll show you this for an example of when not to get things out of date. This did say 27th of May. Yeah, I did. This is bacon that got delivered to me today by Tesco's. I don't think it's going to go into focus. But that sell-by date is the 3rd of August. That got delivered today. I got very upset. Blurred Wolf, welcome to the stream. 3rd of 3rd. There are also other ways to test an egg. There are. That's the one I know. But there are other ways as well. So, we've got our eggs in the bowl. We're going to show you inside the bowl in a second. And we're going to add some of the sugar. Not all the sugar. About 3/4 of what you've weighed out. The rest is for the top of the thing. Now we're going to give this a whisk. Let's get this onto... get this onto a whisk. So like I said, normally I'd use... things. 3 months ago for eggs. How are they not bad? Well stored, mate. Well stored. Panda hates you. Hope you're doing well. So we're going to give this a whisk until it goes pale. I'll show you inside it in a second. I'll just get it whisked up. So at the moment it's very yellow. You can see it there. Just about. So we're going to give this a whisk. Good whisking technique. Try and use your elbow and your wrists. You don't want to put too much air into it. You're just trying to whisk it until it's all together and a nice pale sort of yellow colour rather than a deep yellow. That's what we're looking for. Mate, I don't waste food. If I buy something and then don't end up using it, just keep it. Make sure you smell it, though. Panda hates you. Panda hates me. I don't like pandas that hate me, though. I like pandas. Pandas are lovely. Welcome to the stream. Thank you for being awesome and clicking that follow button. Does your shirt say, Ton Odd Brute Penguin? My shirt says, Do Not Disturb the Bird. But you can't read it because it's backwards. Because I have it backwards. Good whisking technique. Hey, plenty of practice, Ren. Plenty of practice. I am a man, after all. More sniffs, please. Shmoopy going to get food poisoning, not sniffing his food enough. Ah, plenty, mate. Plenty. Yeah, I have to stand quite close to the camera because I need to see. I've just realized I've made double the amount, so I'm going to need 2 more eggs. 2 more eggs and more sugar. When you're doubling a recipe, make sure you double it, guys, and not just use the amount that you're supposed to be using. Bit of advice for you. Double a recipe, make sure you actually double it. Rather than just 1.5 times it. There we go. Chuck that in there. This is the best cooking stream on YouTube. We're not on YouTube. This is Twitch. Gee whiz. Welcome to the stream, Blood Wolf. Hope you're doing well. Food poisoning hype? Hey, we're not playing the long dark. No food poisoning hype. Like I said, we're looking for this to go a nice sort of white pale colour. We're just about there. I'm trying not to put too much air into it. Don't want too much air. Hey, who knows, Kireto? Who knows? What should I call you? I don't really know how to pronounce your name. This song is what we're playing for our marching band show. Hey, that'll be good. Panda hates you. I'm doing great. Fantastic to hear, Blood Wolf. Fantastic to hear. Good to see you again. Welcome to the stream. Move what this? Look, I'll put the lid down for you so you don't get upset. Honestly. It's Kia Serato Hatch 2016. Okay. I'll keep trying. Oh, ye Red... Oh! Yes, by Red 2, please. Oh, we're looking for song requests. I can't do song requests at the moment because my hand's linked. Mango Tan, welcome to the stream. Hope you're doing well. Yeah, sorry I can't put on songs at the moment. It's playing through my Spotify playlist. I don't have an opportunity. My computer won't hold running a YouTube video and streaming. My internet's just not good enough. Let's give this a quick stir. So this is our milk mixture, our milk cream mixture. We're looking for this to be pretty warm. Just testing the temperature. It's pretty cold at the moment. Bowser Dovahkiin! Got my charger 2 minutes ago and I've got 4% battery, but you've made it. Welcome to the stream. Code Nation! You've never seen cooking on Twitch. Are you weird? No, you are not weird. No worries, mind reading fart. Have a good day. Enjoy it. Ah, cool. I'll check that out. I mean, I will check out the song. I'm always willing to look at new songs to add to the playlist. A couple of guys recommended some yesterday, but I haven't had a chance to put them on yet. I'm sorry I have to stand so close to the camera when I'm reading the chat. It's just because the chat's just in not a very good position, basically. Thank you for hanging out today, Mandarin Fart. Have a good day. Coal Nation, it's not weird to have not seen cooking on Twitch. It's kind of new. It's something that I do for a bit of fun. Something a bit different than our normal arc or... what's it, streams? I just completely smashed an egg up and destroyed it. That's okay. Make sure I smell it. I'll sniff it, look. I'll sniff my egg. It smells fine. This one as well. Oh, this one I don't think is fine. Hang on. That is. We're all good. See? Make sure you give it a sniff. There we go. Chuck that over there. I love your head cover. 21 pilots, add them. I will do. Okay, I'll have a look. If they're any good, I'll check them out. I'm always willing for recommendations. I don't know if you can send me recommendations through this, but us small content creators must stick together. Yeah, if you do have a cover, fire it. You won't be able to fire it in the chat because we don't have links, but let us know. Send us a link on YouTube or... send us a link on YouTube. Send us a link on Twitter or drop it to the guys in a private message. I'm sure they'd love to hear it. So like I said, we're using, for this recipe, we're using 50 grams of sugar. The recipe that I've put up on the blog is 25 grams of sugar. I'm just using a bit more because my weighing scales is broken. Oh no, it's not. I've got sugar in it. Ah! Idiot. There we go. It's a bit more sugar than we actually need. Put that back. Fantastic. How we doing? Ah, thanks, Scott. Coal Nation, thank you very much for the follow. Thank you for being awesome and clicking that follow button. Welcome to the stream. Like I said, we're trying to get the this nice and whisked. Again, it's good to have good whisking technique. It's kind of hard to get though. Dovahkiin, I'm glad you can join us. Pleased to hear that your computer's working. Hope you're all having a good day today. So yeah, we're looking to this be a nice pale colour. I'm trying to show you on the screen, but I'm not sure you can quite see it. At the moment, it's still a bit yellow. I'm trying to pale it down. Basically, it's just the sugar reacting with the eggs. Bosch has returned. I wondered if I'd seen Coal Nation before. I knew I recognised the name. Where are the regulars? They'll be around, I'm sure. Dovahkiin, Scott's in the chat. Bosch is a regular, though you may have not seen him for a while. He's been around. Swader's around as well, so don't worry. It's a bit different, though, because we're doing a cooking stream. Sometimes we get things, people are a little bit different. Thank you very much. I'll take a look at that. I might not be able to play it quite yet, but I'll be able to play it at some point. God save me. I'll be back, just going to get breakfast. Scoo auto correct, yeah, don't blame you. How long will this pudding last after it's made? Ooh, about 10 minutes. So like I said, we've stacked all the bread. This normally takes a little bit less time to make, but obviously because I'm talking to you guys, take me a little bit longer. So again, I'm just making sure the milk's not too hot. You don't want it boiling, you want to keep it just below the boil. We're looking for it to be as close to the boil as possible, but not quite there. I'm just going to tidy up some of this mess that I've made. That's the problem with not having Mr. Humphreys. So I've got no one to tidy up. By the way, R2. Falba loved the fact you called him Mr. Humphreys. He hasn't stopped going on about it, actually. So he's very appreciative of his new nickname that you've given him. No worries. Thank you very much for hanging out today. I hope you've enjoyed the stream. And welcome to the stream, Combat Socks. We're in my kitchen today, something a bit different. Thank you very much, Kia Saratohatch 2016. I hope I didn't completely mess up your pronunciation there. So you can see here, our mixture's got a lot lighter in colour. It's not quite there, needs a bit more whisking. Like I said, with an electric whisk, this takes a lot less time, but my electric whisk is behind my setup, and there's no space in my kitchen for it. With you guys. If you guys want to join me in my kitchen, that's great. I was going to eat it for lunch, but I ate it for second breakfast. Coal Nation, mac and cheese. I'm not a big mac and cheese fan, I have to be honest. I don't know if you guys can see, but this has got a lot lighter in colour. So it's not quite as dark as it was. So let's get this nice and whisked up. See how we're getting on. Let's have a quick check of a few things off screen. I know that I'm sort of almost on the screen, but just keeping an eye on some stuff that we're using later on in the stream as well. Fantastic. So, got this nearly boiled. This is just beneath the boil. It's so close. We don't want it to boil. We want to get it nice and close. You made it in time for cooking. Indeed, Finowin. Indeed. Welcome. Hope you're having a good day. Hope work isn't treating you too badly. We've just started. We're making bread and butter pudding. So all we've done so far is sliced up some bread here, put it into a dish. Which you can't quite see because the sugar's in the way. But we put it into a dish here, and we've got it nice and laid out. Now what we're doing is we're whisking up some eggs into a nice light white color if we can. Good whisking action there. Make sure you get lots of air through it. And while we're doing that, we're heating up. Basically, we're making our own custard. This is just a sugary egg mix. Mr. Humphreys isn't even in the chat, I know. I'm sure the stream wasn't the same without horrible puns. Hey, we managed. You're making less impressive waffles? That's okay. Any waffles is fine. Any waffles is fine. Waffles are good. I like waffles. Hope you're all doing well. So yeah, so that says we've got this nice white colour. Nice light air through it. Like I said, I'm using my whisking by hand. It's a lot harder. But hey, good if you're a climber. Gets all those muscles going in your arm. Seems good is the emote I think you're looking for. But I'm not sure. So this is nearly boiling. Nearly scalding. We want it just beneath the boil. Close to boil, but not quite there. This has got lots of air through it, so this is looking quite nice. Basically what we're going to do, we're going to add this to the bread and butter pudding mixture, and then we're going to leave it to settle. So it's a really easy mixture to do. Now, like I said, the recipe's up online if you're interested. You can check it out up there. And then we're going to crack on with our main dish for this evening. This is just the pudding. This is dessert. Nice thing about this is you can make this before you have any guests coming. It's really easy. You can use leftover bread. Like I said, it's a fantastic dish to make with some leftover bread and things. Two-day-old bread is best. So it's excellent. I'm glad you've worked on your thing. Be back in 10 minutes, top. I have to walk the dog. That's okay, Scott. Dogs are good. I'm obsessed with watching the Great British Bake Off. Love cooking shows. This is awesome. Oh, fantastic for knowing. Well, this is almost a British Bake Off recipe. This recipe is sort of a mix of my own, my father-in-law's, and Mary Berry's. I've kind of just taken a few things that I like from each one and added it to my own recipe. My father-in-law is a chef, but his sweets are sometimes somewhat lacking. Keep your doggies happy, exactly. My doggie is around somewhere. She tried to take me out a minute ago. She was in for some leftover bits of bread. It's keeping an eye on my milk. It's nearly at the boil. It's so close to being ready. What we're going to do is once we add this to this, we're going to give it a really fast whisk just to make sure it's mixed through nicely. And then we're going to strain it. Strain it? This recipe I've got written here says strain it. I'm sure I don't normally strain it. The straining is just to take out any of the lumps that are in it. But I don't think we'll bother with that. I think we'll just add it. It'll be fine. Because there won't be any lumps because I'm going to whisk it properly. You see? Cooking shows. There are so many things I dislike. Oh, I'm sorry, Bo to Dovahkiin. I would have made Cook Sisters, but I just don't have the experience or the ingredients yet to do it. Hopefully I'll have them in a minute. Like I said, I'm keeping an eye on my phone because it's this. Kirato Hatch sent us her cover. And unfortunately she's done it to my phone. So let me just see if I can copy it into the chat. Gonna smell amazing when he gets to baking. Yeah, it will do. We've got the oven preheated, so we're ready. Let's have a look. I'm gonna copy this for you guys. Copy. No, I want to copy it. Copy the link. Damn it, I'll have to do it off my computer. I can't do it off my phone. And my computer's not actually open to do it at the moment. Let's just see if I can send. Here we go, guys. So this is a cover of Red. We were discussing it earlier. And we're going to pop that into the chat for you guys. It will smell really good. There you go. That's a song. I haven't actually checked it to make sure that it's not prawn. I may have to ban myself. Hey, you wouldn't want to do that, would you, Smoopy? Didn't actually check it. It was a mistake. Everyone will have already clicked on it. No, I think that is it, isn't it? Yeah, cool. Well, at least it seems to be what it says it is. Excellent. So this is nearly hot. It's not quite there. It's really close. Just testing it with my finger, keeping an eye on it, making sure it doesn't boil. Nice low heat. And this is nice whisked up colour. So what we're going to do is we're going to add the milk mixture to this and roll with it. I followed someone on Cool Combat Socks on Twitter. Don't know if it's you. You're just following anyone. Right. Where's my cloth? so I don't burn my fingers. We're going to add our milk mixture to the egg. You can see us doing that there. Put that out of the way. And we're going to give this a whisk up. So, you can see here, guys, got a nice whisked up mixture here. Basically, it's just milk, egg, and sugar. So what we're going to do now is we're going to switch over to the other screen. Oh, bam! That didn't work. Fantastic. So we're on this screen. Just move everything around a little bit so we've got some space. So we've got this milk creamy mixture here. We're just going to pour that over the bread and butter pudding. Let it soak into the bread. Nice and soak into the bread. Excellent. Nice. So, chuck that in there, chuck that in the sink, get rid of all this rubbish. Again, I'm using a metal pan because I'm going to whisk in it. So that's why I've got a metal one rather than a non-stick one. Move up my mess that I made. Excellent. Turn off the hob. Don't burn my fingers. And a bit of mixture directly on the bench. Exactly. So how long will it last after it's cooked if it's not eaten? Probably 2 or 3 days, I would say. Maybe 3 or 4 days. Meeting, good luck with the cooking. Don't destroy the pan like last time. No worries, Ren. Thank you for hanging out today. Good luck in your meeting. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. So, yeah, probably a few days. Once we've got this mixture, we're going to chuck some more sugar over the top. And this will crystallize on the top and go nice and hard. Just chuck some sugar on. There we go. Nice liberal coating of the rest of the sugar. Bit too much fluff there. I over-whisked it slightly, but that's okay. I didn't destroy the pan anyway. It was fine. Take out some of the fluff. Now we're going to leave that to sit for 30 minutes. This is the most important part. Let the mixture suck into the bread. So that's going to sit for 30 minutes. So what we're going to do is I'm going to pop this behind us. And that, this is when you want to turn on your oven. Get your oven on so that it's warming up. That's the time to get your oven on. So that's our sweet made. It's ready to go in the oven. The oven, it'll take about 45 minutes in the oven. So you want to time it so that it's ready for after. A few days after that, it's just a food poisoning gamble. It's not food, but you're not going to catch food poisoning from it. Trust me, guys. Cook it properly. You won't get food poisoning. So, that is the main dish. That's the sweet. Done. It's ready to go in the oven. We'll put it in the oven in about 20 minutes, and then it'll cook for you guys. I don't know if it's going to cook by the end of the stream. That's the only problem. I hadn't really thought about it. It took me a little bit longer to make than I thought. So hopefully it will be done. Doesn't look like a pudding. It doesn't yet. Wait till it's come out the oven. At the moment, it's just bread covered in custard. It's not really pudding yet. It will be, but it's not yet. Does not. Does too so as well. Right. Enough of that.